This is the clash of the colours, blue versus white, where the working class are coming out on top. Here's a twist. On average, blue-collar workers take home $144 more per week than white-collar employees, with the mining sector obviously offering the country's fattest pay packs right now.
Yeah, new research shows there's a significant link between having a university degree and, get this, earning lower wages. Six of the top 10 highest-paid industries are blue-collar jobs, including construction and manufacturing. Trumping the salaries of jobs which typically, you know, require a university qualification. So does Australia have a new social elite? Joining us now is demographer Mark McCrindle, director of McCrindle Research. Good morning.
Hello.
Okay, this is really significant. Blue-collar industry, blue-collar jobs overtaking their white-collar counterparts.
That's right. It's a big change.
Yeah.
And it just shows that, you know, demand for those blue-collar jobs is outstripping supply. You've got a two-speed economy, you've got older workers retiring, and you've still got a skills shortage there. And on the supply side, you've got a lot more people going to uni. And so that leaves more jobs available for those who want to get on the tools and good earnings as well.
Is this a bit of a trend? Is this a lag after the GFC where the white-collar guys, the high-flying finance guys, aren't doing so well, and meanwhile the plumber you call out for an emergency is driving a very nice car?
It is that.
Just, I mean, moving around?
Yeah, it is that. The finance sector is still shedding jobs. The mining sector, the traditional trades are hiring. Mm. And that does lead to that wages differential. And the fact is, you can't offshore those jobs. You need people here to mine the resources or to lay the pipes, so they're always going to be in demand.
Yeah, you've just touched on those wage figures. They're averages. Are they a true reflection, if we have a look at them?
Yeah, they are a pretty good measure. The fact is that the average full-time worker in the mining sector is taking home $120,000 a year.
Is that someone who's underground, though, for, you know, 10 hours a day?
It's even those driving the trucks.
Okay.
And even those in traditional trades working on the trucks. So you can earn a lot more in the mining sector just because that's where the money is. Finance is at $71,000, which is not bad. By the time you're at education, you're at $51,000. Health at $47,000. So it shows the blue collar is outstripping the white collar worker.
We hear that term, I suppose, blue collar bogan, like it's in some of the you know, articles going around now. It's been thrown around a bit. Does this research have the power to change that that image, if you like?
I think we are seeing that, and it's not just the cashed up bogan. I mean, it's people cashed up in blue-collar roles that are actually the ones taking the overseas trips. It's the blue-collar workers that are renovating the home or spending 50 grand on a new car, you know?
Yeah, yeah.
That's where the money is at the moment, and that's probably going to be a sustained boom.
OK, so they're probably kids now in Year 12 going, "Mum, told you I didn't have to go to university."
Well,
is it a university degree worth it? Providing you don't want to go on and be a brain surgeon or a doctor, but for those people who are looking to earn around that $100,000 mark.
Well, look, a uni degree used to mean dollars. It doesn't guarantee that these days. But I think a successful career isn't about money. It's about finding where your interests and your skills intersect. And so if you're a studious type, go to uni. It's a great background to have. If you're great with your hands, you know, get on the tools and get a trade, because that's going to be in demand into the future. So I think it's finding your interests. There's going to be the money there, but obviously a successful career is more than just the money.
Are there big opportunities for the girls in those blue-collar industries? We're talking about mining and plumbing getting down and dirty. Are there opportunities there?
There are. Look, there is a wages differential there, and the boys are out-earning the girls. Partly, if you look at the lowest-earning sectors, it's hospitality, it's retail, it's administration. We've got more women in those sectors than other sectors. But the mining sector and traditional trades are actively recruiting women to get amongst their ranks. So there's every opportunity there for the women as well.
Yeah, some of the top truck drivers are women.
Exactly. It's not swinging sledgehammers anymore. You know, it's using the technology, it's driving the machinery. Women can do it as well as men, and again, there are active roles there for them.
Very exciting for your new business, Gilly's Guttering. We're launching it today.
Opportunities abound.
Declutter your gutter. You can find us on the web. Thank you, mate. Good to see you.
You're not suggesting the gutter is where I spend most of my time.
I don't even know what it... No. No, more like guttering around the house.
Right. OK, just so we're clear.
But yours is quite good too. I quite like your version better. Thank you,
mate. Thanks, Mark.